I heard something the other day that absolutely blew my mind. Literally, mind blown. When I heard Chris Walker talking with Kevin Dorsey on episode 69 of the State of Demand Gen podcast, mind-blowingly brilliant. They were talking about this idea of paying your customers to actually sit in on your sales calls and not reference calls at the end of the sales process, but to actually jump on your first or second sales call with a prospective customer. And paying them to do that would probably be a much more advantageous way for you to spend your budget than going and spending $100,000 on a booth at Dreamforce. They were talking about this idea and I thought, oh my gosh. And Chris kind of pushed back on Kevin a little bit during the interview. And he was like, well, wouldn't that be a conflict of interest to pay your customers to sit on sales calls? And Kevin was like, it's not more of a conflict of interest than a sales rep who's getting 70% of their commission is based on whether this person says yes or no to this contract. It's not more of a conflict of interest than that is. By paying your customers, your best customers, to sit in on early sales calls to talk about how they're getting value from your product or service, I just thought was mind-blowingly brilliant. But there's one thing that KD and Chris didn't talk about in the interview that I started thinking about after the fact. If you're asking your customer to give up, you know, 5 hours of their month, how does your customer justify the time that they're spending on these sales calls to their company? You're gonna want them during business hours. They're going to have to be accountable to their organization, to their company, for the time that they're spending. And I think the way to do this, and this was a brilliant suggestion from Josh Harkis on our team, what if instead of paying them personally, we just added additional services, added more value in the product or service that they were buying from you in exchange for them sitting on a few sales calls every month? And I thought, that's brilliant, because now they can go back to their company and say, hey, we're getting more value from this service provider or from this product, and all I have to do is sit on a few of their sales calls every month and talk about my experience. Or in our case, what if we delivered more services? So what if we did, you know, a few extra micro videos for that customer in exchange for them sitting on a few sales calls every month? Our customer can then go back to their company and say, hey, I'm gonna be spending a few hours a month sitting on sales calls for this vendor, because in exchange, we're gonna get more value from their service. I love this for so many reasons. It's a win for everybody. It's a win for your prospective customer that's on the sales call. They're getting to hear actual examples from a customer. It's great for your customer and for you. You're building more relational equity. You're creating more depth in that relationship between you and your customer. There's gonna be more collaboration there. If there's something going wrong with that particular customer, probably gonna be more likely to share with you what's going wrong. I just think it's a huge win all the way around. I love that KD and Chris talked about this, because so many marketers get stuck in doing things the way they've always been done, as opposed to backing out and going, what would actually work? Maybe it doesn't exist right now. I don't know of any companies that are paying their customers to sit on early sales calls. I know of folks that have reference partners, people that they've made agreements with to say, hey, you know, if one of our customers wants to do a reference call, can we have them call you? But there's not a lot of structure around that in my experience of what I've seen. Actually going and finding some of your best customers and going to them and saying, hey, would you mind sitting on, you know, 3, 4, 5 sales calls every month in exchange for us unlocking more of our product to you and your team, or more service? They're likely going to want to do that because it's a win for them, it's a win for you, it's a win for your prospective customer. Some of our customers at Sweetfish, it would actually be beneficial for them to sit on a lot of our sales calls, because a lot of our buyers are actually buyers of their product. So here's what I want you to do. Try this tactic and measure it. So for the next 90 days, look at what your SQL to closed won conversion is. How many of your sales qualified leads are converting into new business? Benchmark it know that percentage, remember that percentage, go and ask 5 or 6 of your customers to start sitting on sales calls. Don't wait until a customer asks for a reference at the very end of the sales cycle. Proactively get one of your best customers, give them additional services, give them additional features of your product, pay them for their time to sit on a sales call. Do it for 90 days and see if your conversion from SQL to closed won revenue increases, and then look at how much you spent on it. How much did you pay your customer? How much did you give up in additional services? Was it worth that cost? I don't know. We haven't done this yet at Sweetfish, but I'm going to venture to say that there's a good chance this gives a very positive return to your business. Huge wins all the way around. I love that it's just a different way of thinking, and I wanted to make sure to share it with all of you as well. I hope it helps. Remember, love your team well, hone your craft, and grow your leadership. See you next week.